Okay, so from the tree to the bottle on your table, this is how it all starts. It starts up here in the woods with our maple trees. We have tubing attached starting at the tree, spout into the tree that we tap in usually February. Whenever the sap is flowing, it travels down what's called the lateral lines into our main lines or branch lines, down into our conductor lines, also known as the wet-dry lines, and then it all winds up down into our sap collection house. In vacuum tubing, you want to be able to get the air out of the system. That's your objective. To increase your vacuum level at the tap, you got to be able to evacuate the air. And so if you just had one pipe like this to handle both the sap and the air, it could completely fill up with sap and not allow enough space for the air to get out. So we have what's called a wet-dry system, where this pipe on the bottom is supposed to be your wet line, which is has the sap in it. The sap is supposed to travel down into there, and the top line is supposed to be the dry line, which means there's no sap, it's just for the air to come out. Now sap would be coming down your main line here. It would hit into this manifold. At this junction here, the sap would go down into the wet line, and the air would get traveled and sucked up through the dry line. That's the theory behind it. It usually works. Sometimes you'll see that the vacuum is actually also sucking some of the sap up into the dry line, so it's not fully dry. You'll still have some sap coming through your dry line, but the majority of your sap will travel from your main lines into your manifold system here, down into the wet line, and the air travels through the dry line.